Manufacturing a Helicopter Transmission Bevel Gear by John Pickering and Nathaniel Cook. Every single individual gear starts its life as a blank. Every blank is made of vacuum remelted steel that is heat treated to ensure the best possible results. Every single gear is then stamped with a batch number to successfully ensure the traceability of that part. The first step in the process is the initial turning. The blank is placed within a metal lathe and the center portion is turned to spec. These tolerances are within a few thousandths of an inch and is ready for the next step. The next step in the process is gear cutting. Gear cutting is done via CNC to get rough cutting down to a few thousandths of an inch. And to start the gear cutting process, the teeth of this particular gear will be spiral conical shaped, which transmit power from the horizontal motor up to the vertical blade on the top of the helicopter. The next step in this process is called nitriding. Nitriding is the first step that actually begins to separate this from normal gears. Nitriding is a surface hardening process that introduces both nitrogen and ammonia. Nitrogen ions hit the surface and then begin to diffuse into the steel. This process forms a thin, corrosive, resistant layer of iron oxide. It provides a uniform coating around the entire object and can double the hardness rating and increases surface resistance to things such as wear and tear, torsional deformations, and so forth and so on. After the first round of nitriding, the gear is then ready to be bevel gear grinded. This particular process finely hones the gear teeth down to a few microns, and then the gear is now ready to be moved to the next step. The issue with the previous step is that it actually contacts with another part of the gear. To solve this problem, the gear is broken up into two separate pieces and is then welded together. But not an ordinary welding job is done on this individual part. However, a manufacturing process known as electron beam welding is used. Electron beam welding is the ultimate fusion welding process. Electrons are fired within a straight line at rapid speeds using electrical fields, and the part is located in a vacuum. The impact of the individual electrons convert to heat in very, very precise locations. The benefits of using electron beam welding as opposed to normal welding: the electron beam welding retains up to 95% of its original strength of the base materials. Because of the fact that the actual part is placed within a vacuum, the part is free from oxidation, and since these individual variables are so strict within the welding process, everything has to be CNC controlled. To ensure that everything went correct in the very complicated electron beam welding process, there are a few non-destructive testing that has to be done in order to check out all of the normal safety checks. First up, we have ultrasonic inspection. This is a widely used non-destructive test method, and this process is done through propagation of ultrasonic sound waves to detect defects within a material. Up next, radiographic testing involves the use of X-rays to ensure the welding was done properly. Both of these methods are used thoroughly to inspect the electron beam weld before it can be sent to the next station. One of our last and final checks, the overall integrity inspection. The integrity of the overall gear is checked by the non-destructive testing methods. The gear is checked for metallurgical purities. Because of the fine nature of the gear, no surface defects are allowed. One method that is currently being used is known as magnetic particle inspection, in which magnetic fluorescent particles are drawn to the surface defects. These can be easily identified by a technician. A final check is done via 3D measuring machine. These individual tolerances are down to one micrometer, which is 20 times smaller than a human hair. To wrap things up, a visual inspection is performed on every single part and is then ready for the assembly line. After many rigorous testing, the gear is now ready to be installed into the helicopter's main transmission assembly. The entire transmission is then ran on a test stand, in which parameters such as output torque, vibration, oil pressure, and oil temperature are monitored within a control environment. After the engine passes all the tests, the engine then gets transferred into the helicopter and is ready for its first test flight. These are the following references that we used to gather information on common manufacturing processes such as nitriding, electron beam welding, and the very complicated gear that we have shown you today. And this is the end of our presentation. Thank you.